Randy here. Welcome back to the shop. Today we're going to be working on the new spindle. I'm going to be cutting the threads. I got three sets of threads here to cut. They're all 20 pitch. I got to put this undercut in, and after we cut the threads, we're going to bore it for the drawbar. Then we're going to put the keyway in. So let's head on over to the mill, or not to the mill, to the lathe. Let's head on over to the lathe and we'll get going on it. I got a little piece of high-speed steel here set up for making that thread relief groove. Gonna come in, we'll just touch this edge here right there. Zero that. I gotta come back 585 thousandths. Right there. Let's get these grooves put in. These thread relief grooves need to be 50 thousandths deep. Okay, here we go. Next one. I'll move the tailstock out of the way here. This one. There we go. put the tail stack back here. Indicator here. Okay. Should be okay. Here, 5 thousandths, and we'll make a cut. I gotta wait for the thread pitch to come around here. I'll just back it up. Okay, here we go. Another 5 thousandths here. Okay. Go another 5. make a spring pass here, and then we'll see if the nut starts. See how it... Okay. Swing around here with... Show you what we got here. Nut fits good. There's no appreciable movement in it. Turns all the way to the end. Right like that. Okay, that one is done. I'll do the other two off camera and I'll bring it back. All right, this should be the last pass here. Here we go. Ahead a little bit and see if the nut fits. Yeah, it's a little bit tight. Make a spring pass and then it should be done. Okay. Not cutting. Why is it not cutting? Okay, here we go. Go over that with a file here a second, get the burr off of it. one's still a little tight. All right. Give it just a little bit more. See if it fits now. Yeah, still a little tight. But I'm not so sure if it's the thread or if it's this nut, because I think the one side is tighter than the other. And here, let's see here. No, it's about the same. Yeah. And go a little more. Line this back a little bit here. So I have to wait for the threading dial to come back around. Okay, here we go. Now we'll make a scratch pass. That should be it. Still a little tight there. All right, I got this part set up in the mill here, and I got a cutter. So I gotta come down, make a keyway, 1 inch 275 long from this point over to here. Come down another 15 thousandths. Okay, that should be it. We'll file and clean them burrs off. Beautiful, right? Like that. That's what you want. Okay. All right. I got this thing all assembled here. And it seems to work fairly good. Everything fit. The keyway I put in, that all lines up good. So, and it's pretty good as far as runout goes. Got about a thousandth, maybe just a thousandth and a couple tenths, which is not as good as I hoped, but I guess what can I expect for the way I had to do the taper and that kind of stuff. So, but it seems to work rather well. First cut with an end mill with a new spindle, and I'm taking 40 thousandths off this material. Be working pretty good. All right, let's stop this and back this off. I sped up the feed a little bit just to see what it would do, and seemed to be working just fine. Let me slow this feed back down here a second. This is the second pass I took with it. I slowed the feed right down some, and this is a 30 thousandths pass versus an 80, and it's pretty good. I'm very pleased, and My little trick with the Teflon seal seems to have worked. I've got no leakage out of here at all, like I had in a video where I was machining the steady rest. The oil was just pouring out here, so I call that a win. Well, that's going to conclude this project. I think it turned out really good. So I hope you enjoyed that and maybe learned a little something. I know I certainly did. So that's what it's all about. And yeah, I hope everybody's having a great day. And we'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.